Hi guys, in today's video I'm gonna create this look using only MAC Cosmetics products, so if you are interested just keep on watching. So I'm gonna start with the MAC prep and prime lip. It's to prep your lips for the lip product, but I don't see any major change after using it. I think it could be helpful for someone who has a lot of lines on their lips. Now coming to the brows, we have the MAC eyebrow styler in Spiked. It's a decent eyebrow product which does its job pretty well, and it has a spoolie on the back which is of a great help. It's an eyebrow styler, so you cannot achieve head like strokes with this, but it will definitely give you a very natural look. You can actually see the difference over here. I forgot to put on my lenses, so I did that in between and then going ahead with the other brow. Now I really like this shade. It matches my natural eyebrow color very perfectly, and it's also a little bit waxy in formulation, so it makes the brow stay in place for a really long time. And it's also a beginner friendly product. You can use it if you are just beginning to shape your eyebrows, so this will come in really handy. Now moving on to the concealer, I'm gonna use the MAC Studio Fix 24 hour smooth wear concealer in NW22, and I'm gonna clean the brows and also gonna prime my eyelids with it. I'm roughly applying the concealer under the eyebrows, and I'm gonna use a small flat brush and then create a really straight line below the eyebrow. And now I'm just dragging the remaining concealer down. I'm gonna blend the concealer downwards on the lid using a fluffy blending brush like this one. And once my eyelids are prepped, I'm gonna take the MAC Art Library palette in Flamboyant and take these shades. This palette has beautiful neutral deep shades. Today I'm gonna create a half cut crease look. You can create many different looks with this one palette, and also you can create really simple looks as well. Here I'm packing the shade called Everyone's Darling on my crease, and the shadows are very pigmented, they are super blendable and they don't even have a lot of fallout. Now I've picked up the shade Rule to blend the previous shadow. Now to deepen the outer corner, I'm going to use the shade Dollywood and Embark. This is just to create a base. And now I'm going to use the MAC Extreme 24 hour Kajal eyeliner to create a base for my wing liner. It's a jet black coal which is also smudge proof and waterproof and is super long lasting. I did feel it is a little bit dry. I would have loved if it would have been a little bit more smooth in the formulation part, but overall it's a great coal pencil. Here I'm just blending the coal inwards because I don't want any harsh lines to be here, so I'm just blending it using a very tiny brush. Now coming to the most fun part, that is creating the cut crease, I'm gonna use the same concealer on the same flat brush which I used for the eyebrows, and I'm gonna go in very small strokes. I'm gonna follow my natural crease. You can go a little bit above your crease if you have hooded eyes. Bringing the concealer down without touching the crease that we created, I think blending with your tiny finger really helps. Just make sure that you don't touch your crease. If you are using the same MAC concealer that I am using, you want to make sure that you work a little bit faster because this concealer dries down really quickly and then it's hard to move the product or work with it. Doing the same thing on the other eye as well. Now picking up the shade Samyo Silk and Dollywood, I'm gonna blend it on the outer part of the lid to achieve a very gradient kind of an effect. And here I'm just setting the remaining part of the crease using a powder. Next, using the MAC Brush Stroke 24 hour liner, I'm gonna create a winged liner. It's a great liner. It's black, it's smudge proof, and it glides on really easily. And I really like the point of this liner. It's great if you are going for a very thin and precise wing, and also it's great for your inner corners. One tip that I would like to give you guys is that you want to make sure that you store your sketch pen eyeliners vertically and not horizontally. This is something I've recently learned, and I think it's a game changer. Moving on to mascara, I'm gonna use the MAC Extreme 3D Mascara. It's a lengthening mascara and it separates the lashes really well in just one coat. I personally like using two coats of it, and it does get a little bit clumpy if you go for more than two coats. But overall, it's a great mascara. Now to clean the sides of the eyes, I'm gonna use some makeup remover on a flat brush, and I'm gonna get rid of any excess eyeshadow or fallout before we start with the base makeup. Firstly, for the base, I'm gonna use the very infamous strobe cream. It's in the shade Peach Light and it hydrates the skin. It also adds a very natural glow to the face. I think it's a great product if you have dry skin, as it peeps through your foundation and it gives a very dewy look, but it can be a little lot for someone with extremely oily skin. Moving on to prime my face, I'm gonna use the MAC Fix Plus. It can be used after makeup as well to set your makeup. I like how it helps the foundation and base makeup last long, and it also makes it smudge proof and transfer proof. Now for my foundation, as you guys can see, I'm using the MAC Mini Studio Fix Fluid Foundation in NC20. I like to dot it all over my face and then blend it using a damp beauty sponge. You already saw I just took like one drop of it and it covered my entire face. So it's a pretty full coverage foundation. It's matte and it blends really easily. I feel it does oxidize on me just a little bit, like a half shade, but that's not a problem for me. Just wanted to put it out there. I think it's a great foundation for special occasions where you need full coverage makeup which photographs well and also looks good in person. Here I wanted to go for a very natural base, that's why I just went on with one layer. You can build it up in thin layers if you want more coverage. Using the same concealer that I used to prime my eyelids, I'm gonna use it under the eyes as well to brighten. This concealer gives matte coverage and is super long lasting. It does not crease a lot. It dries down quickly, so we need to work fast with this one. I personally prefer blending my concealer with a small fluffy brush for better coverage. The beauty sponge, I think, takes away the coverage. Now to set the under eyes and my entire face, I'm gonna use the MAC Powder Plus Foundation in NC25. It's a powder foundation, so it does help a little bit with the coverage as well. It makes your makeup instantly matte, and it also comes in really handy when you are traveling, as it has a mirror and a puff in it. I'm just dusting it all over my face. This powder does not create any flashbacks in pictures. Also works really well with different foundation and also as it is for a natural look. Now I'm just adding some contour to the face. I'm using a brown shade from the Flamboyant palette, as I did not have any contour powder from MAC, so it did work. Now for blush, I'm using the shade Melba. It's powder blush, beautiful coral nude shade, very blendable, and is also nicely pigmented. To highlight, I'm gonna use my favorite highlighter of all time. It's the MAC Soft and Gentle Highlighter. It gives a very natural sheer highlight. It's not blinding, but just enough. You can build this highlighter up so you can use it for your everyday look as well as your party glam. For this highlighter specifically, I think the brush you apply with plays an important role. If you apply with a dense flat brush, it creates a strong highlight. But with a fluffy brush or a fan brush, it gives a very perfect amount of glow to the face. Now finishing up the eyes with a blend of previously used shadows on the lower lash line. And I'm gonna also add some falsies and kohl on the waterline. Here I'm hiding the band of the lashes using the same liner. Moving on to the lips, I'm gonna use the MAC lip liner and the Retro Matte Liquid Lip Color. I really loved using the liner. It's really pigmented and it glides on really easily on the lips. It does not dry your lips at all and is very long lasting as well. And next I'm gonna use the Retro Matte Liquid Lipstick. I don't think I need to say a lot about these because everyone liked them so much. So I think, yeah, that is it about this video. I hope you guys liked this tutorial and found it helpful. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button and comment down below which brand should I do next, which brand's full face of makeup should I do next. Comment down below and I'll try to make it possible. With that said, thank you so much for watching until here and I'll see you next time. Bye.